Hi, today's project is this really cute turkey wreath. This is made using an embroidery hoop with tulle wrapped on it for his feathers and then a felt body. First thing we're going to do is make his body. So what I've done is I've taken a piece of paper and I've drawn two circles on it. Sort of looks like a snowman. So one circle is smaller than the other. Lay your embroidery hoop on it and make sure that it's going to cover the distance of your hoop, including your knot at the bottom, okay? You want it to be able to come all the way up. If it's not big enough, then just adjust the size of your circles up or down, and then you'll cut this out. It becomes your stencil to cut out your body. I've then taken my stencil, and I laid it on a piece of brown felt and pinned it down so I could cut out my felt piece. I've cut a second piece of the body out of plastic canvas, and then I cut the plastic canvas around the edge just so it would be a little bit smaller than my felt. I'm going to glue these two together using my glue gun. I want the plastic canvas to be a little bit smaller than my felt because I don't want the plastic canvas to show on the outside of my felt. But I need to put this on there so it gives the body a little bit of support. So I just put a little bit of glue on there, press it down, and we've got our support for our body on there. Now I need to put its face on there. So using a couple of googly eyes, I'm going to glue them on. Let me glue these in place and then I'll turn it around for you to see. So just drop the eyes where you want them using your glue gun. You get some spider webs like I just did, just pull them off. I'm going to create the beak, and mine's a tom turkey, so he's got his little turkey neck here. So I've cut a small piece of red grosgrain ribbon, and I'm going to just glue that on with a little bit of glue. And then I'm going to make the beak. To make the beak, I'm going to take a 5/8 inch piece of ribbon in the yellow gold, and I'm going to fold it into a little cone. Excuse me, sorry. And put some glue on there to keep that cone closed. Now this is obviously bigger than I need. I don't need this part of the tab here, so I'm going to cut that off. And this will get glued right over that little turkey neck on the red part there. Okay, so our body is now ready, so we'll set this aside. We'll come back to this. Next thing we're going to do is take our embroidery hoop. This is a 6-inch embroidery hoop. You can make this larger or smaller. I'm using mine on a 6-inch hoop because I want to make a wreath to hang on the door. You can make it smaller to hang in your window or package toppings or centerpieces, but I'm going to use a 6-inch. And then I'm using our 9-inch wide tulle that I have cut into 12-inch pieces. Take the first piece and just fold it in half. You will then bring the edge around the end of the hoop here and just loop this through. Try to keep your two ends even, but if they're not even, don't worry about it. When we're done, we can trim this off to make it balanced. Pick up your colors randomly. I'm using oranges and golds and browns and rust, a variety of fall colors. And again, I fold it in half. That middle point comes under the hoop. Sorry, let me turn this around so you can see. Under the hoop, and then the two ends come through the hoop, and then just tighten it up. We're going to continue putting our tulle on this from about halfway point on each side. Your knot here for tightening and loosening your hoop will be the bottom of your wreath. So we're going to fill all the way from here to here. Once you've got all your pieces on there, you'll get this pretty, pretty ring. I said if it's not even, you can just come through and just trim it off. You want to make sure these stay where they are. So on the back side, when I've got my last one up on the ring here, I'm going to take a little bit of low melt glue and just put a row of glue on the wooden part and on that last piece of tulle. So those will dry and keep the last piece anchored, which means that the rest of it won't be sliding down either. Now come around to the front here. We're going to put the body on. So the body will come down to the bottom to cover up, like I said, the knot part that tightens and loosens your ring, up to the top part of here. So place your body in the right position. Put a little bit of glue along the bottom part so it'll stay in place. There's my glue gun. You can either glue it onto the wooden ring or you can glue it onto the turkey, whichever is easier for you. Make sure you cover up, like I said, that middle part. And then I'm going to put a little bit of glue up here on the head to anchor it to the top. Doesn't need a lot, just enough to keep it in place. Alrighty. Now I want to be able to hang this up. So what I have done is I've taken a piece of 1/8 inch ribbon. This is about 9 inches long, and I'm going to bring it under the turkey and through a couple pieces of the tulle, and I'm going to just make a knot in this. I can move this out of the way so you can see what I'm doing. I'm just tying my ribbon in a knot so I can hang this up. Like I said, this can be made larger or smaller, so you can use it for a wreath. You can make it smaller to put in a window. Just adjust the amount of tulle that you're going to need. There's about 30 pieces of tulle in this cut at 12-inch lengths. And then you've just got the felt for the turkey with a little bit of ribbon to make his face. And this is it. It's all done and ready for you to hang up and pretty. Have fun making it. If you have any questions, give us a call.